ceremony as well. So welcome to the year's very first felicitation ceremony of Peace Ambassadors. And to do the honors, I'm going to straight away call upon the person who is the founder of this particular movement. Before which, I'll just give you guys a brief about Sir Dr. Huss. An MBA from the Yale University, USA, Sir Dr. Huss is the executive director of Wockhardt Limited and is part of the promoter family of the Wockhardt Group, a leading pharmaceutical and healthcare group. Sir Dr. Huss is the CEO of the Wockhardt Foundation, a not-for-profit organization which runs several programs in health, education, water, sanitation across the country, benefiting and touching millions of lives every year. He is the founder of the World Peacekeepers Movement, an online movement comprising of more than 2 million peacekeepers, forming the world's second largest army. It is based on seven peace values of gratitude, forgiveness, love, humility, giving, patience, and truth. He has won several national and international awards, including 11 knighthoods and 13 honorary doctorates. And over to you, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. Pleasure to be having the World Peace Ambassador. They will be felicitated today. And this is part of the World Peacekeeper Movement. It is an online movement on Facebook, and it was started in 2011. And right now, on this Facebook page, we have 2 million peacekeepers on this page. And here the concept of the movement is based on seven peace values. So the seven peace values are gratitude, forgiveness, love, humility, giving, patience, and truth. And each peace value stands for one day of the week. So gratitude is Monday, forgiveness Tuesday, love Wednesday, and like that. So today is
Friday.
Today we wish each other happy Giving Day. So the concept is, if you give some good human value to the other human being around you, so the opposite of gratitude is to complain, forgiveness is revenge, love is hatred, humility is pride, giving selfishness, patience panic, and truth falsehood. So every day in our life, there's a we have to decide, and there is a conflict, which button to press, the positive button of the human value or the negative. And every time we press the positive button, we get more inner peace in return. And every time we press the negative, we lose some of the peace of mind. So this is the concept of the World Peacekeeper Movement. So today we are going to felicitate the World Peace Ambassadors. So we'll start one at a time. And we first felicitate Dr. Marita Monterio Singh. So Dr. Marita Monterio Singh is a dental surgeon, and she has been Mrs. India Top 30. She is a lifestyle influencer. She is a living example of secularism who follows a culture of harmonious integration of various other culture and religion. She is a core Mumbai executive of NGO Wealth Foundation. So we would like to welcome Dr. Marita, and we would like to honor her as World Peace Ambassador.
Thank you, Dr. Huss, for first of all making me a part of this online peacekeepers army, and also making me an ambassador. Well, I should be rightly asked the question, what I mean by peace, considering that I am now an ambassador of Peacekeeper Movement. Well, everybody has a different way of describing peace, but if I were to explain it in my words, I would say it is a total state of mind which allows us to go back home and have a sound sleep. No matter who we are, where we are placed in life, and what we do, which cannot be measured on scale, and which not only allows self-growth and welfare, but also which is in harmony with others' well-being too. And how I think peace can be brought about, well, according to me, there are two things, two main elements that is the root cause of any evil that happens in the world today, namely greed for money or greed for power, and other thing is ego. Of course, it should not be confused with pride. And I think these two combined together forms a deadly combination which disrupts or jeopardizes any kind of peace. We have seen it, history tells us any be it international or national political issue or even family or personal issue, it all stems from these two things. That's what I believe. So I think a right kind of education, imparting a right kind of knowledge into not just our younger minds but also adults, the uneducated adults, apart from the existing academic subjects, I think more emphasis should be on personality development, and more focus should be on subjects like moral science or human psychology or even right kind of history without any agenda or propaganda or and even geography. I think these things are important to mold a human being into being a better human being, and also it will help the human being to understand the human psychology and human behavior. It all starts from there. So I think humanity should, being a better human being and bringing out the humanity in people should be more emphasized on, as that will supersede the gender, the class, the caste, creed, religion, and even nation. Because if it's a human being, everything else will follow, who will not discriminate or who will be more tolerant towards others.
So thank you for your nice answer.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hose. And firstly, let me, I did not have a privilege of introducing myself personally to everyone. So hi everyone in the room, myself Thakur Anoop Singh. Let me have chance to introduce later on. I'd like to meet everyone. Truly an honor to be here, the first of its kind peace ambassador. For me, I just tell you about my experience about peace. For me, it is a sense of quietness and tranquility, an absence of any kind of agitation and disturbance in my head first, and then the world outside. See, I belong to a creative field. I'm an actor, so in our field, there are times when for particular characters we have to be lonely for the longest of time to get into that character. And that is when my peace is, you know, really destroyed, I would say. So what about me, what I figured out in my life is, for me, when I have a perfect balance between my professional and my personal work life, like my professional work and my personal life, when there's a perfectly, there's a balance there, that moment is when I find peace. Say for example, if I'm 10 days of shooting non-stop and working really hard, and I have 3 days to look forward to meet my family, and I know that I have to get back to my work. So those 3 days are the most peaceful moments for me, because for me, my professional life and my personal life is quite balanced. The moment that balance is a little bit disturbed, my peace goes off the roof. So for me, peace is finding in smaller moments, in the most beautiful moments, where I'm happy to have my workout session on time. I'm happy to. So my entire day schedule is perfectly synchronized in such a way that I've done all my work. At the same time, I go back to my bed thinking, what a day I've had. So that moment is very peaceful for me. Secondly, to answer your question, I'm trying to be as precise as possible so that you don't tell me what's the duration of the. How can we really spread? Honestly, there is, unfortunately, it's not a commodity or a scientific invented something that we actually use and really say that I'm at peace. It is certainly not one man's responsibility, but the entire world's to have, you know, to spread this amongst ourselves. So what I found really is meditation is the key for me. Meditation, if one man, as you said rightfully, the seven values of peace, if one can imbibe and implement those seven values in his life and can be truly peaceful within himself and happy, then he can give it to the people around. And so on and on and on. And so it's like just a give and take kind of a thing. You give me, hey, you're happy, and you give me that kind of happiness, probably I might imbibe from you, and I might give it to somebody else. Because you were nice to me, I might be nice to somebody else. So unless and until we are not really peaceful and happy within ourselves, we cannot expect it to spread. So that's the only way. Am I short and crisp? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, Dr. Hoos, and your wonderful family of World Peace Movement. And it's a pleasure to be on board with the family here. Peace, according to me, is a state of acceptance, appreciation, and a little bit of adjustment. So when we accept the kind of life around us, what God has gifted us, our family, our friends, our neighbors, the values inculcated in us, that's
when you like something and you start finding issues, and that's when the adjustment comes into the scene. But overall, when you start appreciating everything around you, is I believe when you reach a state of happiness and peace. And how I believe we can spread it is where we start spreading everything good is home, our family, our friends, our neighbors, it goes to society, and yes, this is an era of digitalization where individuality is very powerful, can make a lot of difference. So using social media in the right way to have a point of view is good and important, but to make sure that you're not hurting others while doing so is also very important. And I believe in following that, we can somewhere attend, achieve peace in a lot of ways that are now.
Thank you for your answer. Mr. Kudalkar ji, aapko bahut shubhkamnaye aur World Peace Ambassador ka samman aapko mila aur aapke maina mein peace ka meaning kya hai aur hum peace ko hum duniya mein kaise usko phaila sakte hain jo bhi bhasha mein aap jawab dena chahenge.
सबसे पहले तो मैं शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहता हूँ इस ग्रुप का जिन्होंने आज मुझे पुरस्कार के सम्मान प्रदान किया हुआ है. डॉक्टर सर और मेरे बहुत अच्छे नज़दीकी दोस्त और मुंबई के बहुत ही मशहूर से तिरुपति प्रेम जी काकर और साथ में ही मेरे साथ जिनको यह सम्मान मिला है उनको भी मैं बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं देता हूँ. और इसके बारे में तो मैं इतना ही कहूँगा कि आज पूरे विश्व में इसकी बहुत ज़रूरत है. आज जिस तरह से पूरे जग में या अलग अलग देशों में जो भी चल रहा है, इसकी वजह से इसका जो इफेक्ट है वो नीचे के सामान्य जनता के ऊपर बहुत ही इसका असर गहरा असर पड़ सकता है और पड़ा हुआ है. और इसीलिए पीस बहुत जरूरी है हमारे सबके जीवन में और जागतिक स्तर पर भी. और मैं मेरी तरफ से आज वर्ल्ड पीस एम्बेसडर करके आपने मुझे चुना हुआ है. ये मैं सिर्फ चुना और सिर्फ ट्रॉफी लेने के यहाँ पे मैं मौजूद नहीं हूँ. तो यह एक सम्मान के अवसर पर भी मेरी जिम्मेदारी भी है और उस जिम्मेदारी को आपने मुझे उस पर मेरे कंधे पर ऊपर दिया हुआ है, इसका मैं सम्मान करता हूँ. और जितना हो सके उतना पूरे वर्ल्ड में, मतलब भारत से लेकर शुरू करके पूरे वर्ल्ड में आपके जरिए और आप सभी के साथ से मैं जरूर विश्व में शांति के लिए बहुत सारे प्रयत्न करूँगा. यह मेरा शब्द नहीं, बात है.
शुक्रिया आप इधर आए और ये वर्ल्ड पीस एम्बेसडर का टाइटल हम आपको दे सके. तो थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग टू दिस. वी विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट. एंड ऑल दी कांग्रेचुलेशन ऑन बीइंग फेलिसिटेटेड एज वर्ल्ड पीस एम्बेसडर. वी वांटेड टू आस्क यू अकॉर्डिंग टू यू व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पीस अकॉर्डिंग टू यू एंड हाउ वी कैन स्प्रेड द पीस इन द वर्ल्ड. यू कैन आंसर इन व्हिचएवर लैंग्वेज.
हाय एवरीवन, first of all, thank you so much for felicitating me and giving me this honor. And according to me, peace is helping each other in any possible way, whether it is mentally, financially, or you know, just being a mentor for anybody else. If you help someone so they get confident कि जो भी उनका problem है उनको solve करना और mentally उनको prepare करना कि इसको overcome करके आगे बढ़ना है, if they will feel peace inside their mind then automatically वो और भी लोगों के साथ ये चीज़ें share करके एक peaceful माहौल create कर सकते हैं.
बधाई हो. और ये world peace keeper movement का title है तो दिया है वर्ल्ड पीस एम्बेसडर. बहुत शांति का अच्छा काम किया है. आपके मायने में शांति का मतलब क्या है?
अस्सलाम वालेकुम. शांति का मतलब ये है कि एकता बनाना, हिंदू मुस्लिम सबको शांति रखना, लाकर प्रेरणा रखते हैं कि अपने हिंदुस्तान में बहुत जरूरत है एकता बनाने की, और भाईचारे से रहना ये बहुत जरूरी है। इसका हमारा हर हफ्ते को, हर साल को संदेश देते हैं, एक सबको एक जगह बुलाकर सर्वधर्म संभव, इसका एक संदेश देते हैं भाईचारा, क्योंकि हमारे को हमारा मजहब ये नहीं सिखाता। दूसरी बात कि हमारे गुरु ने, हमारे पीर साहब ने सिखाए थे कि एक शख्स मीटिंग ले रहे थे, उसमें सब धर्म के लोग बुलाए गए, आपस में कुछ बयानबाज करने लगे तो सरकार ने सुन लिए और सरकार ने गौसे आजम दस्तगीर बोले चलो खाना खा लो, खाना खाने के बाद पानी का इंतजाम नहीं रहा वहां, फिर उन्होंने बताया कि चलो पानी पीने को चलो कोई बाहर जाते हैं, तो एक नदी पर ले गए और उनको कहे यहां इत्मीनान से यहां पानी पियो, पानी के लिए पीने के बाद मीटिंग लिए और पूछे उन्होंने कि आप सर्व धर्म के लोग यहां पर आए हैं, आपको इस गंगा ने, इस नदी ने आपका नाम, आपकी जात पूछे क्या, सिर्फ प्यास बुझाएगा, हम ये काम करते हैं, लोगों को सबको एकता रखना और प्यास बुझाना, तो भाईचारा रखना। शुक्रिया साहब, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।